for suntan. Suntan, all right?
Brandless berry, Rich. Just fine. Stand by, bro. Okay, stand by to cue, Richie, camera one.
Welcome back here to the MCG, and welcome to Melbourne viewers for the first time today. And my word, it really has turned out to be a marvellous day for cricket indeed. Oddly enough, at around about a quarter to ten this morning, a mass of thick black clouds was hovering over Melbourne, threatening a disruption to the start of this World Series Cup fixture between Australia and Pakistan, and then fuck me if they didn't just disappear quicker than you could say, gee, it's going to piss down. And play commenced as scheduled at 10 o'clock. Just before that, Tony filed this pitch report.
Thank you, Richie, and what a magnificent one-day strip has been prepared here today at the MCG. It's a real credit to the curator, Bob Duruncle, and his staff of groundsmen. And just take a look at some of these cracks here. I tell you, some of these are as wide as the fucking Grand Canyon, and I should think they're going to play real havoc today with some of the batsmen. And with these quicker bowlers like Jeffrey Lawson and double-decker Bass, the Pakistan paceman, well, if they were to whip in a couple of short-pitch deliveries, we could see some real carnage here, and I wouldn't be surprised if someone has their fucking head knocked off. Turning now to our weather wall, well, we can see there that the wind is coming from the northeast at about 15 knots and out of my arse at about 20. The humidity is right on 67% and the temperature at the moment is a rather warm 56 degrees. And when you look at our player comfort meter, well, I wouldn't be surprised if we see a few sweaty jockstraps out there before the day's out and probably a few spots and pimples and rashes around the genitalia area and so on. But all in all, it looks like we're in for a pretty good game here today. Now it's back to Richie in the central missionary position.
Oh, for fuck's sake, Tony, it's central commentary position, you pigeon-toed pea-brain. But nonetheless, it was interesting to note just what an important role this pitch was going to play here today. And earlier this morning, Ian spoke to the stand-in captain for Pakistan, a break me and dad, and asked him how he thought his team would go out there today.
Well, for fuck's sake, Ian, I don't think we stand a fucking chance out there. That fucking pitch, look at it, it's a fucking nightmare. I would not be surprised if we saw quite a few injuries here today. And also, we have lost our strongest batsman, Koptwan Indanaz.
Oh, did he?
No, that's his name, you fuckwit. He tore a hamstring.
Oh, well, good luck today, Abrak, and now it's back to you, Richie.
Well, that's the way it happened, and Abrak Meandad, the replacement skipper for this match, having a few interesting things to say out there. And the Pakistan team would have been absolutely shitting bricks this morning, I'd say. And as it turned out, with some justification, because at the end of their innings, Pakistan all out for a dismal 110 runs. A pretty piss-poor effort, that. They'd be a disappointed lot at the moment, I'd think. And let's take a look at the card now. And you'll see there that they started off reasonably well. The opening pair of Hisa Hasbeen and Idrav Faskars put on 29 runs before Jeffrey Lawson claimed the first wicket for the Australians. He had Idrav Faskars caught behind off a ball-tearing delivery. What a marvellous effort that was. Slightly quicker, well pitched up, and Rodney Marsh taking the simplest of catches to dismiss Faskars for five. And umpire Dick Brain having no hesitation in putting his hand up and asking if he too could be dismissed for five so that he could go and take a leak. Quite unusual, that, really, to see an umpire leaving his post in the middle of a game. But it's a funny old game, cricket, and these days anything can happen. The next man in for Pakistan was Ian Everwaz, and between them, Hisa Hasbeen and Ian Everwaz added absolutely no runs to the Pakistan total, as you'd expect. And in an extraordinary incident, the likes of which I've never seen on any cricket arena anywhere in the world, Hasbeen deflected a slightly overpitched delivery from Rodney Hogg way down to fine leg. The batsman ran one, and then there was all sorts of confusion out there, calls of yes-no, and finally it was Hisa Hasbeen who has run out at the striker's end for 12. And Hasbeen, quite rightly, was pretty pissed off with his batting partner and proceeded to call him all sorts of names. Stupid curry-eating fuckwit, I think, was one of the things he called him, and Ian Everwaz was forced to retire hurt. Very, very hurt indeed he was after those nasty comments. And the Pakistanis were in a great deal of bother out there with the score at just 3 for 29. Sleazy Winebars and Abrak Meandad were the next pair to come in for Pakistan, and they took the score along to 53 when Winebars, who wasn't batting in his normal position today, he's usually one of the early openers, and he just lost his concentration there for a moment. It was a very good ball, that, from Jeffrey Lawson, and it just scurried through and took his off stump, and Sleazy Winebars was out for 22. The next man in was Peanut Butter Jars. He joined Abrak Meandad out there in the centre with the score at just 4 for 60. But he's been horribly out of form, Peanut Butter Jars, and this partnership only took the score along to 71 before Peanut Butter Jars became the fifth wicket to fall for Pakistan when he was caught in the gully by Hughes off the bowling of Rackerman. It was a good effort, that, and the Australians were understandably quite ecstatic out there, as was this marvellous MCG crowd. The place was a real buzz, and we were all bowing up here in the commentary position, I can tell you, and Ian actually shot his load there at one stage, as Australia really began to take a firm grip on this game indeed. A firm grip on this game indeed. A firm grip on this game indeed. Ah, yes, could someone turn the record over, please, for fuck's sake?
Oh, shit. Liz Ritchie, go to commercial break.
Jeff Lawson takes cricket seriously, so he's teamed up with PVC, the imitators in home video.
With my PVC lightweight compact fitted up your nose, take it anywhere video camera and recorder, I can not only spot a batsman's weaknesses. Did I say batsman's weaknesses? Did I? Well, that's what was written on the card.
On this game indeed. Arbroath Meandad was the next to go. He never looked comfortable out there. You could tell he was shitting like a big black Alsatian, really, with the added pressure of captaining the side here today. And he was dismissed for a mere 12 runs off the bowling of Rackerman again, after a magnificent catch way down at long on by Dennis Lilly, it was, the man out there. He had to travel quite a way to get to this, from where he was fielding in the slips. And it really was a very good effort, that, to dismiss Meandad for 12. There was a bit of a wag in the Pakistan tail at this point. Double-decker bus and De Beer Zaire showing a bit of fight. Zaire just working the ball, picking up the ones and twos, before he slipped and fell down one of those cracks in the pitch that Tony mentioned to you earlier. And he hasn't been heard of since. A real bummer, that. But nonetheless, it was a fine partnership by this pair. And double-decker bus was the next to go. He was dismissed by a corker yorker from Dennis Lilly for 35. Corker yorker, a bit of poetry there for you. That's just some of the bullshit that we do go on with here at these World Series Cup matches. And a real battle of wits it was, too, between Lilly and the double-decker bus, right through his innings. As a matter of fact, in the previous delivery, Lilly put one right up in his block hole. And it can be quite painful, that. And certainly a bus not looking too comfortable at all as a result. And Lilly claiming his wicket at the very next ball. The next batsman in was second-hand Kayaz, who went very cheaply for naught. I saw him hitting up in the nets a little earlier today, and I wouldn't be surprised if that had something to do with his poor form. The last man in for Pakistan was Hafiz Hanmasingh, the pace bowler, who managed to score just half a dozen runs before a very quick delivery from Lilly it was, once again, the man out there. And it rose rather sharply and just hit him on the stump. And Rodney Marsh taking the simplest of catches. The not-out batsman was Borat Akadir, who was on 5. And at lunch, Pakistan all out for a dismal 110 runs. A pretty piss-poor effort, that. And my word, they're going to have to work very hard indeed if they're to have any chance of taking out this match. We'll be back here at the MCG in just a few moments.
A message from Sir William What's-His-Name.
Those who are as old as me know what a valuable asset your health is. But you may be feeling a little discomfort lately and finding it hard to relieve. You can invest $1,000 or more in the Australian Property Trust. I wear one and I find it extremely comfortable. They're a strong, lightweight support and you'll hardly even know you've got it on. Most people over the age of 100 really start to feel the strain. And for them, the Australian Property Trust is a dream come true.
For a free fitting and no-obligation home trial of the Australian Property Trust, call into any of our branches.
I strongly recommend investment in the Australian Property Trust.
And kill him.
Welcome back here to the MCG, and just a reminder about our International Cricketer of the Year Award, the winner to be announced on February the 5th, and the prize, this magnificent Datsun Insult. It's a fine piece of machinery, that. You see it on your screen there, the one with the dents all over it, and the souvenir ball on the front seat. And I suppose the strong contenders for this award would have to be Vivian Richards, the master batsman from the West Indies, and also Joel Garner, the well-hung West Indian pace bowler. And in the Australian team, well, I would think Kepa Vessels, who's had a superb season with the bat, as well as taking his fair share of wickets. And it wouldn't surprise me if the Australian selectors were trying to blood Vessels for the captaincy of this Australian side. Pretty awful joke, that, blood Vessels. But who gives a fuck? Just a reminder also about our classic commentary competition. It's just another one of the 50,000 competitions that we're running here on the wide world of sports this summer. And in this one, viewers are asked to nominate in the same order as the groundsman here at the MCG. the classic pieces of commentary made by the team over the past few months. And my word, there's some crap in amongst them. And we'll let you have a look at those a little later on. Your entries close on the 2nd of February. And your entry forms can be picked up at all fish and chip shops right around Australia. The Sidchrome Super Test Team is another one of the competitions that we're running here. And remember, we are looking for a test team made up of the players who look the most like spanners.